Hi, we're here on the floor at DesignCon 2024, and we're in our good partner's booth, Keysight. And what we're here to show to you today is the world's first USB 4 V2 PHY IP running at 80 gigabits per second. The USB 4 V2 PHY IP runs at twice the speed of the previous USB 4 V1 spec, which runs at 40 gigabits per second. Now you might ask, what's the big deal about this? Well, USB 4 V2 will enable future applications where you can have a desktop or laptop that has USB 4 V2 connectors, and they will connect to multiple high definition monitors, say 6K or 4K monitors, connected to ultra high performance external SSD drives, connected to a hub for all your legacy USB and other types of peripherals, elegantly connected by a single USB Type-C cable back into that laptop or desktop. And so USB 4 V2 really enables the next generation of host and device connectivity. But even more exciting, in this AI age, we see the potential of this 80 gigabit per second connection enabling future next generation AI accelerators, where you could have a reasonably cost desktop or laptop connected through a USB 4 V2 cable to an AI accelerator. So you can do more of that local AI processing at the edge instead of today having to go back up to the cloud. There's an exciting number of applications that are yet to be seen that could potentially be done at the edge with AI and potentially all connected by the USB 4 V2 cable. We have our USB 4 V2 PHY test chip. It's on the board right down here. It's residing in a socket. It's next to an FPGA on this characterization board, which we use to control the test chip, the output and everything. And we basically are measuring and characterizing the full performance of the IP itself over process voltage and temperature. And with that as a quick introduction to the board, I'd like to introduce Jit Lim from Keysight, who will come in and describe a little bit more what they're showing on their equipment today.
Thank you, Jeray. Signal integrity in a PHY IP is critical to future success, whether it's about yield, about cost, about time to market, about reliability, about our customer experience and satisfaction. Fundamentally, we need to have superior signal integrity and quality. And what does that mean? We all know what an eye diagram looks like. And in this case, we have the world's first showing of a PAM3i at 25.6 gigabaud. You can clearly see the superior signal integrity of this PHY IP. Very open eye, very low jitter, very clean signals. So large signals, what we call linear fit pulse, low noise, sigma n, and low error, or sigma epsilon. These parameters are combined into a PAM3 measurement called SNDR, or signal-to-noise distortion ratio. It's essentially the numerator is a linear fit pulse divided by sigma n or sigma e, and in this view, you see significant margin in this beautiful piece of V2 PHY IP. That margin will be required to ensure a great customer experience, the open eye and the SNDR. So I'm personally super excited when I heard that this silicon would be available. And I'm so proud to collaborate with my friend Gervais and his silicon to be able to publicly show this wonderful signal integrity at DesignCon. So thank you, Gervais. I'll hand this back to you.
Thank you very much, Jit. Appreciate all the kind words. But more importantly, the purpose of our joint collaboration here is to demonstrate we have the IP, we have the test equipment to enable the next generation of USB 4 V2 designs. And we just can't wait to see what the future brings. Thanks for watching.